the next generation COVID-19 vaccine on the horizon. In recent times, we have a lot of rapid progress on the development of mRNA vaccines like COVID-19 vaccines. But the challenge of mRNA vaccine waning immunity over time persists. A recent development in the realm of COVID-19 vaccines has sparked considerable interest, particularly in Japan, where a novel mRNA vaccine has been approved. This vaccine, known as LunarCoV-19, operates on a similar principle to other mRNA vaccines, delivering instructions for producing the virus's spike protein. However, what sets it apart is its unique ability to also instruct the body to generate more mRNA, effectively allowing for the production of more of the vaccine within the human body itself. We call this self-amplifying RNA vaccine saRNA. This innovation offers several potential advantages over traditional mRNA vaccines. In theory, self-amplifying RNA vaccines have three key benefits. Firstly, due to their inherent self-amplifying nature, they can achieve comparable levels of protection with significantly lower doses. Secondly, the prolonged presence of self-amplifying RNA in the body may result in a more enduring immune response compared to standard mRNA vaccines, which typically degrade within a few days. Thirdly, indicating that self-amplifying RNA vaccines has potential to solve the challenge of mRNA vaccine waning immunity over time, and thereby provide prolonged protection. Simply put, self-amplifying RNA vaccines' function is like sending a set of instructions via text message that not only guides the initial process, but also continues to provide guidance without any external input, much like a self-replicating software. While the concept may seem unconventional, it underscores the intricacies of biological processes that goes on within the cells. Despite the notion of a vaccine that replicates itself within the body possibly raising concerns, it's important to clarify a few points. Although the genetic material utilized in these vaccines is derived from viruses, it does not contain the information necessary for producing the virus itself. Therefore, self-amplifying RNA vaccines cannot produce new viruses. Additionally, while self-amplifying RNA persists longer in the body compared to traditional mRNA, its amplification is not indefinite. The approval of LunarCoV-19 in Japan follows promising results from a large-scale trial conducted in Vietnam, which demonstrated its efficacy and safety in humans. In a recent comparison with another COVID-19 vaccine, Comirnaty, LunarCoV-19 showed a higher percentage of individuals developing antibodies and maintained significantly elevated antibody levels a month later. The company behind LunarCoV-19 has initiated the approval process in Europe and is also exploring its application for influenza, including both seasonal and pandemic strains. Research on mice has demonstrated that self-amplifying RNA vaccines could provide equivalent immunity against influenza with just a fraction of the dose required by conventional mRNA vaccines. We will make further updates on these developments later. We will keep you updated on this if you subscribe to our channel and hit the notification bell. Note that knowledge is advancing by the day, and we will like to always post an update on new advances on how to stay healthy. You can contact us via the links in the description below for any medical inquiry. You are watching Zoom Hospital Channel and listening to Work of Dr. Kayode.